Hello students, good day. In today's session we are going to learn how to create series in Python. Okay, series, so we know what is series. It is a one dimensional structure. So this is one of the data structure available in pandas. This is used to store values. Okay, and this is capable of holding data of any type. So here we can see the example. You can store string values, you can store numbers, integers, floats, and all other data types you can store in series. But this is a one dimensional data structure, so it has data and index associated with it. Normally index starts with 0, okay, and we can change the index also. We can have the string index also. So that is the main difference between NumPy arrays and then series. NumPy 1D array also we have a index associated with that, okay. So that index is always numerical value, and here we can change the index. We can change the index to string, float, or any other data type. Okay, so now how to create series? So pandas series can be created with the method called series method. So S is capital here. So you have to use this method to create the series. The first thing, we have to import pandas module. So this module should be imported. It will be loaded to your computer's memory. Then you can use the methods inside the pandas module. Okay, then you can so how to import the modules, right? So like we did for NumPy, import NumPy as MP. So we have given some identifier for that one. Like that you can give identifiers for pandas also. So here first we have to know how to create empty series. So series object, this is syntax. Series object equals to pandas dot series. So we are passing no arguments inside this series method, empty list. Okay, so this create empty series. Okay, so let's see the example, and then we can also create the series method. You can use the series method with arguments. So it accepts two arguments. The first one is data, and then the next one is index. Okay, so this data has a positional argument. If you pass first value, all the first value will be considered for data values. And then index, there is a second argument. Argument name is index, and then you can give the list of values for this index. So a data can be a sequence of list, ND array, scalar value, Python dictionary, or any mathematical expression. Okay, so in the data we can pass a list, we can pass a ND array, scalar values, and then Python dictionary, and then any mathematical operation instead of this data. And then index, we can give numbers and strings, characters. Okay, so let's see the first example, how to create an empty series. Okay, so this is my program. The first line, import pandas as PD. So first thing, we have to import the pandas module into our system. The next one, S1, this is my object, series object. S1 is equal to PD dot series. So this is the empty list. Okay, no arguments passed inside the method, and we are just printing the S1. So let's run this program. Okay, so here you can see series and then empty. Okay, this is called empty, and then the default data type is float. Okay, now so here what I'm going to do, I'm going to pass some values for this one. So we know the first one is data, and that data should be a list here. The first thing we are going to do the demo with a list. So I'm creating a list L1 with a series of values. So let's take some 10, 20, 30, and then 40. So this is my list. I am passing the list over here, okay, L1, okay, and I am not passing any index as of now. Let's see the output, then we will see the index. Okay, so now the pandas series method, I am passing only one argument. Okay, so you can see this 10, 20, 30, 40 are the values we are passing, and automatically the indexes are created. Indices. Okay, so first one, 0, it starts with 0, 1, 2, 3. So automatically index created. So next one, instead of this index, we can pass the index value also. So I'm passing index equals to, so I'm passing 10. Okay, let's see some alphabet value, A, B, C, and then D. Okay, I am creating another list. Okay, this list contains the values A, B, C, D, and I am passing this list for index. Okay, so L1 it takes this list, and for index we are giving a separate list here. Okay, now you can see this one ABCD or the index now we are created, and then this one is assigned accordingly, right? And then as you know, we have to make count of the index. So the values for that equally we have to pass the index. So if you are giving four values in the list, then you have to pass four values in the index, right? So if any one of the value is float, so you can see this output. This series is of data type integer because all the values are integer. Okay, this is the data type. And if any one of the value is a float value, okay, then other values will also be converted to float, and then the result will be float values. Okay, you can see it here. 10.0, 20.0, 30.8 and then 40.0. So this is the float data type, right? So as we know, we can pass the characters also, or you can pass any string also. So let's see, we can create a string with, January, February, March and then April. So this is a string value we are passing. So you can see the output, Jan, Feb, March and then April. So we can pass string values, integer values, float for the list. Okay, so next here, instead of passing the index argument, you can change the index value using the property, index property. Okay, so we have to use S1. So this is the pandas object created, series object created, that index s1.index equals to, you can pass the list over here. Okay, so instead of passing index argument to series method, we are altering the properties of this series using this one. So s1.index equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. So in this way also you can give the index value. Okay, so Jan, Feb, March, April, and then the indexes are 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. So next. Okay, so we can pass string values, alphabets, and then numbers, and also we can change the index value. So the next one, what we are going to do, so in the index, I'm giving a repeated index. Okay, we can have the repeated index also, right? So 1, 2 and then I'm giving 1, 4. Okay, so the now index is for Jan also 1, for March also 1. So this way also you can give the index. So there is nothing wrong in giving the repeated index. Okay, so this is when 1 for Jan and again 1 for March. So if you display the value, so instead of yes, you can display the index. So you can use S1 of 1. So this will display the content of first index. Okay, what is the first index here? Feb. And then, so here we have one more index. So one index 1 is Jan here, and then index 1 is March here. So this statement displays both values. Okay, you can see it here. 1 is Jan and then 1 is March. Okay, you can have the same index for the values. So next one, so this is my next program. Here I'm creating using the list, I'm creating a list using the range function. So you know what is range function, right? So this is the starting value, and then this is the stop value, and this is the interval, right? So we can use the range function to create the list. And then for the index, I'm calling the method called list. Okay, list of, you can give any string value inside this one. So for all the string value, each character will be passed and each character will be assigned as a index for the given range. Okay, here I'm creating an index 10 to 60, which means and the interval is 10. So first value is 10 and the next value is 20, 30, 40 and then 50. So totally 5 elements will be there in the list. So for that one, we have to pass the index value. And then this index is, I'm giving 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 1 is assigned for 10 and 2 is assigned for 20, 3 is assigned for 30, like that. So you can see it over here, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. This list is created using the range function, and then the index is assigned using the list function. Okay, so here you can pass string values, any string values. So you can give A, B, C, D, E. Now the list is, index is changed to A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so this is the use of list function, and then this is the use of range function. We can also pass the range function here. And then next one, okay, so next, this is the function. This method uses x for x in range. So we are using the for loop inside this one. Okay, so you can see this first one, importing pandas. Next one, I'm creating a list with Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. This is my list elements. And then I'm creating a series S1 with pd.series. I'm passing this list here, L1 here. And then for the index value, I'm giving x. So what is x? For x in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be taken. 1 will be taken for x. So that will be assigned here. So like that, all the values will be separated. And that is the x value that is assigned for index. Okay, so this way also you can pass. Right. So you can see Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And then the index is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then. So as we know, this is positional argument. Okay. So if you pass any value as the first value, that will be considered for the data. And if you are passing the data as the next argument, then you have to use data equals to, okay, so data equals to L1. So one way you can pass it as a position argument, first argument, and other way you can mention the key, mention the parameter name as data equals to L1. Like this also you can specify. So it will give you the same output, right? Okay, so next one. Instead of passing our own value for list, we are getting the values from user. Okay, so this is the interactive program. We are going to create the list from the user. So the list and then index, both the values are retrieved from the user, and we are going to create a series. Right, let's explore this code. The first one, import pandas as pd. We are importing the pandas module. I'm using the identifier as pd. So next one, I'm creating two empty lists, L1 and then L2, empty list. And then next one, n is the variable which has the values, enter the number of students. For example, so this program is used to get number of students and then students' marks. We are going to create a series with marks and students. Okay, so for that one, first time we have to know how many students we are going to input. So that's what we are using the n value. For I in range n, for all the values of n, for example, if you are using 5, and then 5 records will be fetched from the user. Okay. So for I in range n, first value we are getting the name. Input, enter the student name. Right. So since this is a string value, we are not converting that one. The next one we are getting the mark. So that one is of integer. So we are converting, enter your mark, that is a string. The values we are getting, and then that is converted into integer, and that will be assigned to mark. Okay. The first student's name and mark is received. And then we have to append that one, L1 and L2. Okay, L1 is a list for name and L2 is a list for mark. So L1.append, now this name will be added to L1. And then L2.append mark, this mark will be added to L2. So this loop will be repeated one more time and till number N. Okay, so if it is for two records, it will be repeated once again. And it receives the student name and the student mark, that will be appended to the list L1 and L2. Now we will have two list L1, L2 with name and mark. Okay, so next one, we have to just pass the name and then mark. So here I'm using L2 mark as an index. Okay, and then L1 is an index. Okay, L1 name is an index value, and then L2 mark is a data. Okay, so let's run this program. So it asks for number of students. Okay, so for I'm giving number of students as 3. Okay, so number of students as 3. Right. Let's run this one now. Okay, so now 3 students. So first student's name. Let's say Naman. Enter mark as 90. And then next one. We have Bishar and then Marcus 97. Then next one we have Pooja, then Marcus 78. Okay, so totally 3 records. All 3 records, name and mark, are received now. Now the series is created with Naman 90, Bishar 97 and Pooja 78. So here Naman, Bishar and Pooja are index, and then here 90, 97 are data. Okay, so this way we can create a series with the input from the user. So let me explain the code again. So 2 empty lists are created. So L1 list is for name and L2 list is for mark. So we are getting the number of students using the input statement that is stored in the variable n. So that many times the loop will be executed. We are each time we are getting the name and then mark, and the name and then mark are appended to respective list. After getting all the values, we are creating a series with the values L2 and L1 as index. Okay, so here name as index and then the marks are data. So in this way, you can create interactive program and interactive series. Instead of passing list value directly to the program, you can get the values from the user. So we have seen different ways of creating series, the series method, and then we have only 2 arguments, data and then index. So what kind of values we can pass to data? So basically in this session we learn how to pass a list to series method and how to create a series using the list. Okay, so in next class we will see how to create a series with a nd array and how to create a scalar value, all those things. Thank you.